You're watching Mato episode 6. Episode 6 is a landmark episode for me. When I started this channel, I was worried that I wouldn't have enough ideas or thoughts to sustain the channel, but here I am at episode 6. I'm excited. So some quick information for you. 6 represents luck to the Chinese. In a biblical sense, 6 represents man and also his carnal side. So just some trivia information for you. Something I'm going to try out starting from episode 6. I'm going to talk much faster to squeeze in more content within 15 minutes, because you know, uploading videos to YouTube can be quite a pain. Something else I'm going to try out is talking softly or almost whispering, to see if that improves the sound quality and reduce echo in the feedback. So March is an exciting month. You know, it's, time has really flown by. We are already one quarter into 2012. So this month is what I consider the month of the Avengers, you know, with the return of the Marvel Legends and quite a number of Avengers characters in the wave. You know, it's also because of the upcoming movie. You know, I'm pretty excited about that movie. And you know, coincidentally, I got this Avenger, the Wonder Man, mint on card 2 nights ago from a local eBay seller. So he was offering this guy on auction at a very reasonable price, so I decided to snap him up. So here you can see a pretty cool figure. Frankly speaking, I don't really know much about this character. I've seen him in a few storylines, not really as a main character but as a supporting character. So the latest graphic novel I read that had him in it was The Secret Invasion. He was one of many superheroes fighting the Skrulls. He comes with a complimentary yellow jacket in a miniature size, so that's pretty cool. The blister packaging is in really, really good condition. So at the price I got him, yeah, I'm pretty satisfied with that. So besides picking up this Wonder Man from that local eBay seller, I've also gotten hold of the Spider-Woman. She was originally mint on card as well, or what I thought was mint on card, but when I brought the packaging home, I realized that there was this humongous hole in the blister, so that's why I took Spider-Woman now. I know this character or this figure is quite popular amongst the ACBA community. No offense to you guys, but I think that she's probably easily one of the worst Marvel Legends figures ever. Out of the packaging, her right leg is extremely loose. I originally wanted to pose her together with my Loki, kind of like in the discussion about how to take over the world, but I ended up having to put her on the flight stand because she probably can't stand very well on her own. The torso articulation is horrible as well, and if you notice, you know, her arm is extremely warped. So not a particularly nice figure in my opinion. You're probably wondering why I have my Ultimate Cap beside her. Well, that's a very good explanation for that. Voila, my updated Avengers display. I just received the Steve Rogers and the Extremist Iron Man from the Return of Marvel Legends Wave 1. I got the two of them last night from one of the guys from the trading page on Facebook. He made me a really good offer, and I decided to snap up these two figures to update my Avengers display. So yeah, I pulled Steve without his pistols because it would be quite strange for him to be holding his pistols in a relaxed pose in this portrait. I originally intended to have him holding his shoe, but as I realized for myself, yes, you know, as well, a lot of you guys have already feedback, the shoe is too small, not really to scale with this figure, and I have to agree with that. So I decided to leave his shoe kind of holstered on his back. The extremist Iron Man, yeah, he's pretty small in size compared to some of the other figures. But I like the detailing on this Iron Man armor. In fact, I prefer it to the Iron Man figures from the Iron Man movie series. So I'm quite happy with this figure, and I like this portrait. You know, I would think, yeah, this will be the money shot. Okay, so besides these two guys arriving last night, something that came together in the package from Mark Williams. Okay, is this bad boy? So Icicle from the Public Enemies series, a baddie that I've been wanting for the longest time. I'm glad I finally got him at a reasonable price. So just a quick review. You know, I love his color. I like his translucent features, like his fingers and his face. So really awesome. I like the comic book look. Very contrasting to the realism offered by the last son Zod, or the new Krypton suits. So just a different feel. Both sets are nice, but it's quite refreshing to have comic book depictions every now and then. Okay, very quickly moving on. So what I've done, okay, with the use of the Green Hulk in my Avengers display, I used the Ultimate Hulk as a replacement for my Hulk versus Skrull battle display. So here you have the Grey Hulk kind of flinging a bunch of Skrulls off his back or his body. Really cool. It took me a very long time to get them nice and balanced. So I'm quite happy with the final result. So having said that, probably I would say, bam, this would be my money shot. Cool. So yeah, that's the updates I have at the moment. I have some more stuff on the way, so I'm pretty excited. Before I forget, a quick shout out to some people who are dear to me. I mean, of course, I've mentioned Mindless quite a lot of times, you know. In fact, the display stands, the flat stands I use for the Hulk vs. Skrulls display was provided by him. Big thanks to Mindless. You know, we meet up every now and then to catch up and to exchange goodies. So, very nice guy. Another Singaporean from the ACBA community, Fats. Very nice chap as well. We chat quite frequently on the on Facebook. You know, he's one guy I would like to meet eventually. So that's something on the to-do list. Oh, but coincidentally, I'm meeting him tomorrow because he's passing me a Deadpool, the Hasbro Deadpool in the blue and yellow suit. So yeah, having said that, I'll finally get to meet him tomorrow. So outside of Singapore, of course, there's people like Big Daddy. You know, even though we are separated by an ocean, but he's one of those guys where you know you do not have to physically meet, but you have that connection. So a big shout out to Big Daddy. All the best on your move. We'll definitely keep touch on Facebook. Of course, I hope to be able to meet him one day. Also, hi to T-Rod, very interesting lady who's into comic books, action figures, and of course, ACBA. So, hi T-Rod. Some other people like, hi to AJ Frost as well. I don't really know him. In fact, never really corresponded or interacted with him, but he was kind enough to leave very positive comments on my YouTube channel. So big shout out to AJ Frost, dude, you rock. So other people that I want to say hi to, oh my gosh, how could I forget Book Nice, the guy who started it all, the ACBA art form, getting me interested in doing dynamic poses, getting me passionate about building up my Marvel Legends collection. So definitely, what somebody I hope to meet someday. Book, I'll be in New York mid-August to late August. If you have some time, I'd like to meet up, possibly chat about Marvel Legends, ACBA. Maybe you could bring me to your favorite comic book shops and toy shops to get some goodies. Shout out to other guys like Anthony's Customs, Stevie Customs, Daniel P, Michael Beretta, so and so forth. So whoever I've forgotten, I'm sorry, my mind is kind of drawing a blank at the moment. It's not that I don't appreciate you guys, but it's just a slip of my mind at the moment. So anyway, that's all from me. This was Marto episode 6. Till the next time, take care and ciao.